Earth isn't round, it's flat.
How do you know?
I've observed it in all my travels over Europe. It's flat, everywhere it's flat.
Okay. So, to start with, हम तुमसे basic easy questions पूछेंगे. कोई right or wrong answer नहीं है. Before that, one trick question. Who is the first person who went to the moon?
Neil Armstrong.
इसमें trick question क्या था?
First person who went to the moon. I said who stepped on the moon first.
Okay, nice. The question was the same. The first person who stepped on the moon. Neil Armstrong. ट्रिक क्वेश्चन क्या था इसमें कि हमको लगता है कि नो वन एवर वेंट टू द मून.
यस,
लेकिन फिर भी एग्जाम में अगर पूछा जाएगा तो तुमको लिखना पड़ेगा नील आर्मस्ट्रांग. नील आर्मस्ट्रांग. ऑन अ स्केल ऑफ 1 to 10, हाउ ओपन माइंडेड आर यू?
7
मतलब डिसेंट इनफ, नॉट वेरी ओपन माइंडेड. सो व्हेन प्रेजेंटेड विथ इंफॉर्मेशन or maybe any kind of argument that goes against what you already believe, how easily are you going to accept it?
That depends on at what, to what extent it is like changing the viewpoint, what earlier it was established. Pehle se jo thought hai uska kitna depth tak ja ke wo thought totally uska opposite hai. If it is not much in depth, then I will go for some changes if it hasn't any negative impact now or then.
Very good. Do you think your thoughts are your own?
Many are my own. Many are influenced by others around where I am living, because thoughts are the things, our surrounding play a major role in the thoughts that we develop. The environment team we lead, the people we interact with, they influence our thoughts.
Do you think anything as or something as original thought?
Yeah, it's a very original thought is like base thing that will take you to new heights.
Can you give me an original thought of yours? अभी बोले ना कि तुम्हारे पास है, some thoughts are my own and some thoughts are socially and culturally conditioned in our minds. So what is your own thought that is not conditioned in any way?
I should ask a thought in which area or which respect you are asking about.
Any thought,
like for example, like if I'm thinking about my own personal thought, then I would like to, in case of career, I would like to go for business now only. But if I go for society and family background, family culture, and then I should go for a job first, secure my life, and then
again they are thoughts which are you think your own. But do you think no one has ever thought of it before?
Everyone is thinking about either doing
a business or maybe getting a job. So how is that your own thought? That is a thought that is well prevalent in the society.
According to me, I am defining it in my way as the particular time I am going into it. Like at this point of time,
okay,
the society thinks that at this point of time I should go for further studies and should build up a safe career. Then I should go for like this time of, as we all know today, business is the most risk factor in every field. Okay, so
fair enough. The sun rises in the
east.
2 + 2 = 4. What do you think is the shape of this earth?
Not elliptical, not much sphere.
It's not an exact sphere, but it is a
ball.
It is like a ball. I don't think so. I think that the earth is flat. And we are not spinning.
This evidences that the scientific evidences prove that the earth is
like
round. Like
First of all, you have got to realize that there is a difference between an evidence and a proof.
Yeah.
You realize the difference between these two. So anyone can show you a photograph and tell you that it is an evidence of our round spinning ball earth.
Okay.
But it is not a proof of that. Right? So whichever you are comfortable with, I would love to hear. Evidences can be falsified.
Yeah, they can be.
A proof, a scientific proof is something which is repeatable, demonstrable, and anyone can do it wherever they are.
Okay.
So we will if you want, you can get it to evidences also, but I would like you to give me a proof that we are living on a spinning ball in the absolute vacuum of space.
The very strong proof is the satellite images that we have got nowadays to explore.
So again, the first thing I said is images are not proofs of anything. You have your phone,
yeah.
You can always Google,
yes,
images of Earth from space. NASA has very high definition
and
very good
camera.
Images. Now, do you realize that there is a difference between an image and a photograph?
Yes.
An image is a computer generated
image,
CGI, special effects, and a photograph is an
original photograph.
Now, NASA in their website declare that none of the photos, they cannot say legally that they are photographs, so they have to say that they are
picture,
images.
Image.
They're computer generated images, or basically images and not photographs.
Yeah.
And even the person who creates all those photographs, you can Google him. He has a radio interview that he gives, and he says that all of them are photoshopped. So that is not even an evidence, let alone being a proof. Anything else?
The gravitational field or the cosmic interaction of the Earth with the cosmic rays, those things can be explained only when we assume Earth as a sphere or nearly a circle. So
yes, they work on the assumption that the Earth is a globe. So first we are assuming that it is a globe, and then
satisfies the natural facts, that the natural laws that are with us, those are defined with the
like
assuming that
what natural laws?
All the gravitational laws and the
gravity, do you know they call it the theory of gravity?
Yes.
Newton gave the laws of
motion.
But the theory of gravity. So there is a difference between a scientific law
and
a scientific theory. Gravity is just a theory. And the basic thing that you need to know about theories is that a theory has not been
proved.
It is just a scientific concept, consensus that all scientists have accepted. Right. So gravity is just a theory. I do agree, I do not deny that maybe there is a force. Even scientists say they do not know what gravity is. Gravity is a mysterious force. So
earlier it was as considered.
I can realize that things go down when dropped.
Okay.
Right. But how can the same force make water stick to the exterior of a ball which is spinning at thousands of miles per hour? Right. Is it not counterintuitive?
If a object is moving, then certain amount of force is acting on each of the particles in that object. So if that would happen, if there would no gravity, then water molecules would stick to the, should move out, but they are in packed form. Gravity is some force is there which is withholding everything in all.
Again,
body.
It works on the supposition that we are a ball and that we are spinning. Otherwise, we know that water, when left, large amounts of water stay level. You are an engineer. An engineer must know that water stays level, because
water
that is what we
level, right?
Because that is what we use for huge constructions in order to maintain a level that is our benchmark. Right. That water does not curve.
The surface of it.
अब वाटर के नीचे का सरफेस कैन बी उबड़ खाबड़, बट द सरफेस ऑफ इट इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी फ्लैट. यू हैव ऑब्वियसली सीन अ ग्लोब एंड मोर देन 70% ऑफ द अर्थ इज वाटर. सो वाटर हैज टू कर्व एट सम पॉइंट. आई डोंट एक्सेप्ट दैट बिकॉज आई डोंट सी इट एज माई रियलिटी. इट इज़ नॉट ऑब्जर्वेबल. And since I'm denying all the pictures of NASA and other space agencies that they send, there are no pictures of the curvature of the Earth. So why is it so elusive? Why can we never see the curvature of the earth?
The thing is that every imaging thing that we have is comparatively very, very much smaller than the curvature radius of earth. So when we picturize or try to capture that curvature, we are only capturing a part of that curvature which seems to be flat. For example, if we take a football and place an ant on it, for ant or smaller ant, you can say, for that smaller ant, that football would seem to be flat for that point where the ant is standing.
Correct.
Even if he moves a bit further from the football, then only the ant can see only a small part of that big football. Then also it will appear to that ant as a flat surface. So that's that's the thing. We cannot see the earth as a whole because of its massive size. The thing,
what
that
is the size of the earth?
3 lakh kilometer radius, I think.
3 lakh kilometers radius or circumference.
I'm just messing up that point.
You are way off, be it the radius or the circumference. The circumference of the earth is 40,000 kilometers, 6,500
radius
kilometers. It is not that huge if you come to think of it. And we all know, we all can do spherical trigonometry in order to determine that at what gradient that curvature is going to fall below our eye level, right? After going some distance, it is going to fall a little. You are saying that it is too minuscule a fall. But we can do the calculations.
Yes, we can. But the calculations differ when we go from like microscopic level to macroscopic level, and the things changes when the things to be considered are become very much bulky, like the planets and the solar system. So in that calculations, as many kinds of assumptions are always taken. So the laws that we know are already prevailing in nature. We are just conceiving those things, observing those things, and making some statements. And after that, the things that we know, we are relating with that new thing, applying some assumptions, new theory, new kind of laws. And if that satisfies what we prevailing know or comes close to it, then we get to say that the things that we have assumed is pretty much right. In that way, I think it was assumed that the earth is round, and the things that have been assumed.
So why are we assuming things? Since when did we start assuming things? It never looked round to us, right? We had to come up, or we have to tell a child that what you are seeing, what you are feeling is not correct. Actually, you are spinning or moving faster than a bullet, thousands of miles per hour. And that water conforms to the exterior of a ball. That is something which is an outstanding claim, and outstanding claims require outstanding proof.
So,
I don't think there is enough proof for us to believe. Why do you believe what you believe? Have you ever tried questioning what you believe? That it may not be so. So we were talking about the moon landings. So you are well aware that there are, for lack of a better term, conspiracy theories that we never went to the moon. You can easily understand that flat earth is the mother of all conspiracy theories. But I don't really like that term, conspiracy theory, because it was created to undermine those who are trying to question the authority about their narrative of everything that goes around in this world. So CIA created the term conspiracy theorists after JFK's assassination, John F. Kennedy's assassination, because people were coming up with things like, no, it was not a real assassination, there is something fishy over there. And CIA came up with the term conspiracy theorists to label all those people who are saying that we don't believe the official story, the mainstream narrative, simply to give them a tag that they're crazy. So I don't really like that term, but there are people who believe that we never went to the moon. What is your opinion on that?
The the evidences, I should rather say evidence, not now, but the evidences that have been put forward by the officials, or you can say NASA, in particularly, the things that they have presented quite seem similar to what we have in our mind, the image of moon, like what kind of...
Is it not the other way around? That you first
have that...
you were first presented with that image, and then you think that it is my, just like you said, you think that it is my original thought without ever realizing that it was planted there in your mind when we were too young, too naive and impressionable. We were not critical thinkers at the age of 5 or 10 maybe, depending on your education. But now as critical thinking adults, we can question things. बचपन में हमको कहीं बोला गया, सबको बोला जाता है कि भूत है, सैंटा क्लॉस है.
That's the thing, whatever people are knowing at later ages, that is the thing that they have been taught at earlier stage. Those things they grow up into in his or her mind, and then they develop thoughts related to that, and then they use those things what they have learned to understand the world in a better way. So what we have been taught in earlier days, we are using those theories to relate the new things that are coming around. We are analyzing whether they match up with the what we have learned, or it is totally different. If it is totally different, then we try to understand like what are the factors that are making it totally different. If those factors are quite good, or they have quite good ground of support, then we accept those thoughts or those
ideas.
So I'm
saying they have all these thoughts that you are talking about do not hold the ground when put to the test. Flat earth is a thing on the internet. Are you aware of that? That there are people in this world who believe that the earth is flat. I am not the only one, unfortunately. But in India maybe, I am quite new. There are people. So, what is your opinion of such people?
I think...
Do you even consider the possibility that you can be wrong?
Wrong earth? Very basic thing is, if the earth would have been flat as they are saying, then if a person is standing at one end, he would be able to see the person at the other end, but we can't see the person at the other end if he's standing just opposite to us. So that doesn't... The flat
so can
thing
we see then, forever? If the earth were not a ball, you think that we can see forever?
Yes.
For as long as possible.
Yes, the visibility of normal human eye is up to till infinity, as we can see the stars.
Uh-huh.
So if it had been at one end, that is you are saying it is flat. If it would have been a flat, then it must have one end. And if a person is, two persons are standing on opposite ends, and if the atmosphere is quite quite visible condition, then they could have seen each other.
So do you realize that railway tracks converge at some point?
Railway tracks converge.
When you're looking at a railway track, you're standing at a railway track, and you look. This is how perspective works. The two tracks are going to converge at the horizon.
But it's just an illusion. It is an illusion that they will converge at that point. But actually they are not converging. They are going parallel to each other.
They are going parallel to each other, but they are going beyond your eyesight.
The factor is that angle of sight.
I mean to say that we cannot see forever. An aeroplane looks huge on the ground, but it looks
tiny
when flying in the sky. If it were flying even higher, do you agree that there will be a point beyond which you will not be able to see that aeroplane?
Definitely.
Or do you think that we should be able to see that?
Definitely, after a certain point of time,
we won't be able to see that plane. So now you were saying two people at the two ends. Why do you think you would be able to see that other person?
Okay, if you replace the two persons by some huge object, like if you consider like bigger object than plane or something, like we are able to see the stars and all that, those are huge as
I don't believe the stars are millions upon millions of light years away. I think they are close. The sun and moon are much closer on the flat earth model than we have been told. So again, you are working on the assumption that they are millions of kilometers away. I am saying they are not. And what you are seeing even to believe that you are seeing trillions upon trillions light years away is absurd, don't you think? Because the light from the star started traveling billions of years ago. So actually what we are seeing today
has been emitted a time before,
yes,
much time before.
It's all just a theory that we tend to accept without ever questioning it. So I am questioning it. So don't give me that it is a proof that we can see for millions of kilometers. We cannot. On a hazy winter day, because of fog, the visibility reduces to 10 meters.
That is a specific case you are
saying. So I'm saying that looking up at the sky where the atmosphere is getting thinner and thinner, right? And looking across a flat plain where the atmosphere is constantly thick are two different things. So we should not be able to see beyond a certain point. Both because of perspective, things get smaller due to perspective, and also we cannot see forever because human eyesight has a limit.
Limit.
Any other point?
All the evidence sources that have been given, the assumptions that have been made, that have scientists have considered it square, and everything has been like the laws that
so it's a belief.
Belief.
You don't know that it is a spinning ball. You just believe that scientists must be telling us the truth, and you tend to believe them simply without
the
ever questioning.
I would like to explain this with an example.
Please do. Can you hold this for me?
Like, if you are considering a thing, like if someone is explaining a theory, okay, he is explaining a law, you have understood as he has elaborated or explained you that law or theory with some examples, and you see, yes, these examples are quite good, it goes with the law or theory he has placed, and you are quite visible with that proofs. Now if we see if we set this similar kind of example in this case, earth is flat or round case, then we can also, the laws that have been proposed by scientists, if we apply this sphere assumptions to these laws, and
laws
if
like
the cosmic rays laws and the gravitational,
what does that law say?
Cosmic rays, like the rays that are coming from the sun are like revolving around the earth and like that thing. If it is a sphere, on
so a law states that if it is a sphere, then this is happening. How can I accept it as a law when there is an if in it? Do you mind?
No.
Do you want one?
No. Thanks. Pretty much assumptions are made from earlier that these things are already there, and we are assuming.
I am simply asking you to question those assumptions. Question what you have been told. Do not blindly accept what you have been presented as your reality. We are living in a very bad world. That's my point of calling you here and talking to you.
Okay.
We are living in a world full of lies. And the sooner you realize that, the better off you will be. For example, the moon landing, various other lies. If the earth is flat, I know that it is flat. I am in no doubt about it. Okay. If the earth is flat, that naturally compels us to believe that all space agencies of this world are somehow complicit in it. Have to be.
Yes.
So that means all governments of the world are working together.
Yes.
You must have read Dan Brown and similar other novel writers. Do you think there is some kind of a secret society, or the powers that be, people at the top echelons of our society who are controlling everything, basically controlling the population, the masses.
That is the thing.
Recently, because of Cobra Post and everything, you must be aware that all news channels are just showing us stories.
Yes.
Whichever political party or other interest groups they are associated with, affiliated with, they tend to show a painted picture in their own news channels. So that is, you could have tried telling that to your father 10 years ago maybe, would he have believed it? No. But it is common knowledge today, right? I forgot my train of thoughts, but my point is that you are living in a world of lies. So how can you so gullibly just believe what people are saying? I'm asking you to question things. And when you look, when you start looking into it, when you start looking into the, for example, the pictures sent by NASA, we also have a thing called the IAS, ISS, International Space Station, floating in the sky. And they also stream live videos. There are people floating over there in zero G. We just believe that all these things are true, but when you look into it and you actually put some time and effort, basically research, to look into what they are showing us, it will be so clear to you that it is all fake. Outer space is being faked for us to believe that we are living in a globe which is just a speck of dust in this entire universe. Your lives mean nothing. You spend the first 20-25 years of your life just to understand the world you are living in and to make yourself good enough to live the rest of your life. If you start questioning things, don't you think you would you would think that, is it all that we are supposed to do in this life? Is it all we are here for? To get a good education, to get a decent paying job and lead the rest of your life like that?
Thing is that the things that they are showing, or the thoughts or ideas that they are putting in front of us, they have supportive statements regarding that in many cases, in everywhere.
So liars
and
are
those supporting
colluding together. Many liars are colluding together.
So one
liar is supporting the other liar is supporting the third liar. This is what you mean to say? So you believe the first lie because it has been supported by the second lie, and the second lie has been supported by 1,000 other third lies. So this is what you basically mean to say. I'm saying that you are living in a world of lies. I don't just believe or take things at face value. If we are living on a ball, there has to be some calculation for the curvature, right?
There is,
and you can also look for it online. There is an online curve calculator. The curve goes like, for every kilometer that you go, or for every mile that you go, there is a drop of about, for every mile, which is 1.6 kilometers, there is a drop of 8 inches. And the formula goes like, miles squared times 8 inches. So for the first mile, it is 8 inches. For the second mile, it is 2 into 2, 4 into 8, 32 inches. For the third mile, it is 72 inches. Right. So beyond a certain point, a certain distance, it should be impossible for us to see things which are over that curve or beyond that curve. Do you know what is the longest distance photography record? Guinness World Record for the longest distance land photography. It's 440 kilometers. He is seeing a mountain which should be hidden below 5 or 6 kilometers. I'm talking about kilometers, right? 5 or 6 kilometers below the horizon, and he is taking a picture of that. Now again, the cosmic ray law and everything comes up with an explanation that actually the light is bending across.
Due to the presence of atmosphere, it's bending.
Atmosphere and gravity.
Gravity doesn't have effect on the light. because
sure about that.
I'm pretty much sure about it because light does not consist of any materialistic particle.
Photons?
And gravity.
What are photons?
Photons don't have mass in them. And gravity, as we have read, or the law that it has been given, is gravity acts on every object that has mass, and light photons does not have any mass. They are just reflected by the atmospheric particles, and so we are seeing the objects that are below the horizon.
Mm-hmm.
Horizon.
But you are saying that there is an explanation for that.
Mm-hmm.
So it is not a proof that it is flat, but somehow we are able to see what is beyond the curvature because of some other atmospheric
natural
conditions, which again you cannot prove or even give evidence for.
Yes.
Am I wrong in believing that your explanation is a little too far-fetched, and I will stick to my explanation that it is actually flat. There is no curvature, which is why we are seeing what we are seeing. Is it not a more simplistic explanation?
The thing is that if you go with that theory, if you are assuming that Earth is flat, okay. Now, whatever the natural things that have been established, all those big equations and all those things,
like
the equations that have been developed by scientists, gravity equations,
anything other than gravity.
Earth ke case mein. Scientists are like projecting rockets and everything else through some motion equations.
No, they are not.
According to particular equations, they are the particular velocity and everything else.
No rockets are going anywhere.
Then, if you assume that it is flat and...
I'm not assuming, I know it is flat. I know that rockets aren't going anywhere.
Then where are they going? They are just taking off from land, and where are they going?
Landing somewhere else. Have you seen a rocket launch yourself?
Not with eyes, but on TV and everything.
On TV.
But there are people...
What is the trajectory?
Huh?
If it is going into space, should it not go straight up?
No, it has to... They're like... then the theory comes. If we consider Earth to be... if we consider Earth to be a sphere, as we have presumed, then revolve around the Earth, it should go at a particular angle to the surface of the Earth to make a complete round around the Earth or wherever else it is going to get a particular path.
Okay.
Because if it goes straight, then उसको एक particular trajectory में जाना पड़ेगा.
एक video है बच्चे का, जैसे we as adults see rocket launches because we know it is going somewhere and it is going to make a few orbits of the of the Earth before leaving for Mars or wherever the hell it is going. एक बच्चे का ये है, record करते हुए एक बाप अपने बेटे को दिखा रहा है rocket launch. Rocket ऊपर गया क्या क्या क्या, and the moment it starts coming down, the kid is like, dad, something is wrong with that. So his dad says, no, it is going alright. Like, are you sure it is going on? I think something is really bad with that. It is coming down. So, his dad says that no, it is actually the spin of the Earth and it is going on. He gave him some explanation. I'm just telling you, if you change your point of view, a kid's point of view, I'm trying to give you, which is untainted, which has not yet been influenced much, sees what is right in front of him. But we as adults, whose thoughts have been so programmed and so conditioned that we do not see the reality right in front of us. It is flat because it looks flat. We are not spinning because we don't feel spinning. But you are told to suspend all your natural senses and believe what authority is telling you. Right? Do you feel the spin of the Earth? Do you know how fast we are spinning?
But the
why do we not feel the spin? I know your answer still.
In the spin, the forces are quite balanced in nature. That's why we aren't feeling that we are spinning on that Earth.
So when I move in a car, I do feel that I'm moving.
Oh.
don't I?
But no, the thing is that the relative velocity things come into picture in that thing, that your relative velocity becomes zero at that point of time if you are spinning with the earth. So if you consider us with respect to the exterior from earth, like space,
mm-hmm.
then we are also spinning with the earth at the same velocity.
Okay.
But since suppose my velocity is v and I am stepping on earth which is also moving with velocity v,
mm-hmm.
okay, so then how can I feel if my with my respect to the earth is at rest? That's the Newton's basic law. If a body is in contact with another body which is both are moving at the same velocity and their relative velocities are zero in the same directions, so we can't see the relative
so you mean
motion
to say
between
two,
earth and me,
two trains running parallel to each other,
mm.
at a speed of 100 kilometers per
if
hour.
Both are running at 100.
If both are running at exactly the same speed.
They will see each other at a steel.
So you mean to say when you look out, you are only relying on your sense of vision.
Vision, huh?
So by seeing that the other train is not moving and neither are you,
mm.
you will believe that none of you are moving.
Mm. Because that is the relative case.
But then you want me to believe that you are not going to feel yourself moving, except even if you close your eyes, wouldn't you feel that you are moving? Even if the train is completely vibrationless?
If I close my eyes, huh, then I won't be feeling that the train is moving.
You won't feel that.
If there are no vibrations or that kind of things, like any external forces acting.
You won't feel the air or you won't feel anything.
As I said, if any external thing is not applying on your body and you are just closing your eyes and sitting on that train, you won't be feeling that the train is moving or not.
Again, there is an if.
Yeah.
But in normal conditions, whenever we move...
The motion and all these things are perspectives. What we see with our eyes, with our senses,
mm-hmm.
we perceive all those parameters and then come up with a particular result. Like if I am standing here and that any object is moving from this place to this place, our eye sees that it has been misplaced from that point to that point. That is a sense that is going to our mind. We are conceiving those parameters and coming up with a result that yes, the object is moving from that to that point, and we are and in that certain point of a certain time interval, and we are calculating the velocities. All these things are perspective.
So have you seen
in
a
nature.
Tennis ball which has water basically, which has been soaked in water,
mm.
and then you throw that ball after
mm.
dropping, it
mm.
starts spinning.
Yeah.
What happens to the water on that ball?
Water just split out.
Right.
Farther from the world.
Okay. Why is it not happening with our earth?
The thing is that then again the gravity things come into
gravity.
Play.
Okay.
That is, it is holding us tightly, like not going. Okay.
So if gravity were not there,
mm.
we would fly off into space?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
First of all, we will die because the air would go away.
Air would go away. Fair enough. So even gravity is holding the atmosphere
mm.
to the outside
mm.
surface
jacket.
Of the earth,
jacket,
it's like a jacket.
Mm.
And as we go up, it starts getting thinner and thinner
mm. Mm.
because the air above,
the force of gravity is what we say decreases as we go farther from it, because it's dependent on the distance from where it is the center.
And now that we are moving,
mm.
even the atmosphere is moving along with us.
Yeah. All the things are holded as a whole, and whole thing is moving.
Even the atmosphere.
In the atmosphere, yes.
Okay. So.
Because atmosphere is what consists of particles, and particles are withheld with the earth, and they are also moving there.
But then, how is the air connected with this earth? How is the atmosphere connected with the earth? Earth is moving.
Mm.
How is the atmosphere also moving along at the same speed?
The earth is moving. It's like a jacket, and we are moving from place to place, and different points we are taking. Like it is a earth. Atmosphere is just like a jacket which has withholded in direction perpendicular to the
okay
earth.
So my simple question would be, for any practical purposes,
mm-hmm.
we do not need to take into account the curvature of the earth first of all and the spin of the earth. This is what you're saying, because everything
mm-hmm.
is moving at the same speed. So
for considering things which are on the earth, we have not to we need not to consider the spinning and those curvature things.
So the earth is moving in a particular direction from east to west. ठीक है.
West to east.
West to east. Now, if there is a plane which is also flying west to east,
okay,
with the motion of the earth, and if there is a plane which is going opposite to the motion of the earth, like the earth is spinning in this way but the plane is going that way, and the other case is the earth is moving this way and the plane is also moving this way, in both the cases we do not need to take into account the spin of the earth, because once an aeroplane leaves the surface of the earth, it is by its own, right, in the air.
Here we have to take the spinning of the earth into account to know the difference. Because if you look into the theory that if you move, take off from a point and move to another point, the theory, the earth spinning theory comes into play, then only we can go to some other place, like this place moves to that part and we are going to that one. Like, that thing, if you go into deep, you will know that this spinning theory is applicable in that plane, like plane moving from one point to another.
So you have a basic idea of the globe and the position of the continents, as we have been told. America is to the east and we are moving from west to east. If we had to go to America, why don't we just take a helicopter, hover it over the earth for maybe 10 hours, 20 hours, and wait for America to come below us. Let the spin of the earth do the trick for us, and when America comes below us, just come down. A helicopter, or you can take the example of a hot air balloon. If we keep a hot air balloon above this point for 10 hours, is the earth going to move below it, or is the balloon also going to move along with the earth? Because the earth is spinning really fast. So in like 6 hours, it is going to traverse 1/4 of the entire circumference. Because in 24 hours, it goes round. 6 hours, in 6 hours, if we leave that balloon up there, we should be a quarter of the circumference of the earth away from where we originally left the balloon. Is it actually the case?
No, that's not the case.
Why not?
Scientific theories have been given, like, if we, that's not the case, like,
so in case of a aeroplane, you said ki we will have to take into account. In case of a helicopter or a hot air balloon, we don't need to take into account because of some laws and theories.
But we won't be able to reach at that point. Some scientific theories are there and they have explained it well, but I'm not recalling that part quite clearly. So,
but you are sure that there are some theories that explain it, right? Now, the earth is spinning, you must be aware of angular velocity. So a thing moving about this point in a small circle with a constant angular velocity as another point which is moving around the same point center in a bigger circle. So they are going to complete one rotation in the same amount of time. That is, they have the same angular velocity. But linear velocity, the particle which is farther, is going to be much higher than that of the smaller circle, right? Linear velocity, because it is traversing a much greater distance in the same amount of time. So the angular velocity is the same, right? Accordingly, the centripetal or centrifugal force is also going to increase or decrease.
That depends.
It is going to be much higher in that bigger circle. Now, if we consider a person who is at the equator of the earth, and consider a person who is very close to the poles,
forces are differently.
But gravity is constant.
No, gravity, the value of gravity changes with equator and pole. That's the basic fact. The gravity of the G value is minimum at the pole and maximum at, minimum at the equator and maximum at the pole. Scientifically, these
How much is the difference?
Like, it is around, I'm not recalling the exact value, but it is around 0.2 or 0.5, like this. like at equator it is exactly 9.81,
okay.
but at a pole it is much a bit greater than 9.81.
A bit, right? Not very great.
But it is considerable. We can consider that thing in calculations because the things when we go in scientific calculations, little things matter a lot. But and that small number is creates the difference.
Okay. So, the not so equal centripetal force, which is going to be much different at those two positions is being equally compensated by that small difference in gravity. This is what you mean to say.
Yes.
Okay. Fair enough. Aur batao. Yes, we are talking about the atmosphere. So what is space? Space is vacuum. We know how vacuum behaves. On
no,
Earth,
no pressure.
No pressure. So, if we create a pocket or maybe one small container and create a vacuum inside that container,
okay.
Vacuum is a very strong force, right?
Kind
so
of.
If we don't make the outside surface of whatever cube we are making, it would just the outside atmosphere is going to bump into that, and there will be no vacuum, right? Vacuum is a very strong force, and it sucks. Everything into it.
Actually, the vacuum is not sucking. The external force are applying on that. Like, vacuum is nothing but zero force. Okay. And on Earth, we are experiencing force. So, force when this force is acting on a zero thing, obviously it would crush it out. And that is the case. Vacuum has zero force. And if a vacuum is created on Earth, and we have external forces on Earth, that is in the form of pressure force, gravity force, and many other forces. So, when those forces are combinedly acting on that vacuum which has zero force, obviously it would crush it out.
Now let's try to picturize the edge of the atmosphere,
okay.
The point where atmosphere ends and vacuum begins. Why is that vacuum outside our atmosphere not sucking the atmosphere in?
That's why I've said vacuum does not have any kind of force. It is zero force. The force is with us, that is with the Earth, and it is towards the center of the Earth.
How do you know that?
Theory, that laws that have been given to us.
But you can't prove it to me. How can you prove that gravity is a force acting towards the center of the Earth?
Gravity is a force acting. Because, there are quite laws that have been put forward, which says that the
I know all of them. I'm saying, can you prove it to me?
That the force is acting at the center.
Towards the center, yes. Because I drop something, it is coming down.
Okay.
Now, we have been told that there is a force pulling it towards the center of the Earth, which is obviously perpendicular to the surface we are in. Now, what makes you... Why can I not say that there is a force above, which is pushing it down?
Pushing it down. If some force were there, like you are considering that there are some forces which are pushing us down, but if some objects are kept in vacuum, it moves randomly. If some object is putting set into vacuum, it moves random without any.
Don't confuse vacuum with zero gravity. Vacuum is not zero gravity.
You are considering, like you are saying that some forces are acting on the particles of the Earth and they are putting it down.
No, I'm just saying, given an explanation that there is a force pulling it down, I can also say that there is a force pushing it from above. So what makes you think that there is a force pulling it down and not a force pushing it from above? Obviously, your answer is theories and laws and everything. That's not good enough for me because I said ki I do not accept all those theories.
Okay.
I'm sure that the laws always work, but I'm very skeptical about the theories that they put forward. Now, do you believe in evolution?
Yes, that's the basic thing. We have come up to this point of time. at this point, like our past generations or the ancestors, the evolution is the thing that has developed our the basic thing, that is mental condition, body condition, physically, environmentally, everything has been come up with evolution. That is the basic thing of nature, the developing nature of developing thing in nature.
So we
evolution.
Have been told, right? But have you looked into evolution? Do you think it is a really watertight theory?
Again, it comes to those, in case of evolution, we can see the facts, there are quite good, strong facts related to it. Like,
are you aware of the facts contrary to evolution, or the facts that negate evolution?
There are quite number of facts.
There are scientists on both sides of the argument.
There are, but the facts that have been put forward by them are quite strong, as if considered in the evolution side, that we have evolved from our ancestors, or the earth is day by day evolving in its own.
I am saying that many scientists have come together to accept evolution as the only explanation and as the correct explanation.
Because
so
that is satisfying all those things,
yes,
that they have.
But
I am
saying that just consensus does not mean that it is true. Right. Because before Galileo said, the consensus was that the earth is flat. Right. Then Galileo was the one who was ostracized and put to jail and everything. All just stories. Or kya point? So you could not prove it to me yet. अभी तक हमको कुछ ऐसा नहीं मिला जिससे कि मेरा ओपिनियन चेंज हो जाए. आई होप कि तुमको कुछ ऐसा मिला हो कि जिससे तुम्हारा ओपिनियन थोड़ा सा चेंज होने का चांस भी हो, और एटलीस्ट वी आर गोइंग टू लुक इनटू इट. जस्ट लाइक आई सेड कि देयर आर पीपल ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द आर्ग्यूमेंट, एवोल्यूशन का फॉर में भी, अगेंस्ट में भी है. तुमको बचपन से पढ़ाया गया है फॉर वाले के साइड के तरफ से, बिकॉज दैट इज द साइंटिफिक कंसेंसस. बट इज इट द रियलिटी, इज इट द ट्रुथ? यहाँ पे आ जाता है वो सारा चीज़ कि जस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव बीन टोल्ड बाय अथॉरिटी, इसका मतलब ये हो गया कि वो सही हो गया.
एंड द थिंग इज, इफ यू आर नॉट गोइंग विद दोस थिंग्स, इफ यू आर पुटिंग फॉरवर्ड दैट लाइक द वेरी थिंग दैट यू आर,
इट इज कंप्लीटली ओके टू से दैट आई डोंट नो मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स, एंड सिंस आई एम न्यू टू इट एंड आई एम नॉट रेडी टू बिलीव व्हाट आई हैव बीन टोल्ड, सो देयर विल बी थिंग्स व्हिच आई डोंट नो एंड आई एम ओके विद दैट. एक्सेप्ट instead of getting wrong answers or duplicitous answers to your questions, it's better to have questions unanswered, don't you think? At least you have the right questions, you are asking the right questions. Now your respite is for everything that interferes with your common sense. I should say, if we are not spinning, still we are spinning. You tend to accept the explanation that has been given to you.
Because the other side don't have quite strong explanations to give.
Have you tried to look into it? Have you ever?
Not only, many people have tried to look into that.
So again, you are trusting others to do that for you.
Because everything we know, the knowledge that we gain, it is from other people. Okay. That is influenced by, now then it is influenced by other people. What things that have been told by others, that has been taught from very childhood, we grasp those things, and after certain point of time they become a part of our own thoughts and thinkings. So that is the
but
case.
Again, that does not dictate what is true and what is a lie, what is false. You may believe whatever you want to believe. There are people who believe that,
but the very thing to distinguish between whether a fact or a statement is true or false, that for a human perspective, that depends on what supporting statements have been given on both sides. If a side have been given,
for everything you need to have a statement from someone else for you to believe whether it is true or false. There is no such thing as self-evident truth.
Then the thing comes that what our self thought, self thought are all also being they have been. उसको बचपन से वैसा सिखाया जा रहा है, तो बड़ा होके वो वो
रहना कि टेररिस्ट्स को कहीं ना कहीं बचपन से सिखाया गया है कि तुम जवानी में सुसाइड कर लेना, सुसाइड बॉम्बिंग और ये सब कर लेना, तो वो सही थोड़ी है. अब उस बच्चे के लिए वो सही है, और उससे भी अगर तुम सवाल पूछने जाओ तो वो भी बोलेगा कि हम जो कर रहे हैं इससे बेटर कुछ नहीं है. राइट, आई सी दैट राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी. अभी तुम बोल रहे हो कि हाँ हमको जो बताया गया है हम तो वही मानेंगे. आई एम जस्ट आस्किंग यू टू क्वेश्चन थिंग्स. आई एम नॉट सेइंग कि तुमको एक झटके में जिंदगी भर का 20 साल का जो तुम्हारा इंडॉक्ट्रिनेशन है दैट वी टेंड टू कॉल एजुकेशन वो चेंज हो जाएगा. बट आई एम सेइंग कि क्वेश्चन थिंग्स. स्कूल में जो पढ़ाया गया है इसको कभी क्वेश्चन किया है क्या? बहुत सारा हम लोग डिस्कस करते हैं प्रोनाउंसिएशन वगैरह ये सब में कि हाँ बताया तो ये गया था लेकिन इट इज़ नॉट प्रोनाउंसर. सो आर यू रेडी टू एक्सेप्ट न्यू इन्फॉर्मेशन इवन दो इट इंटरफियर्स विथ वॉट यू ऑलरेडी बिलीव? सो उसका पॉइंट है कि तुम जानते हो कि क्या सही है क्या गलत है. तुमको ये पता है एंड यू हैव ऑल द रिसोर्सेज टू फाइंड इट आउट फॉर योर सेल्फ. ठीक है, मेरा बोलने का मतलब क्या, आई डोंट टेक माई वर्ड फॉर इट, बट एटलीस्ट लुक इन टू इट. जो सेम चीज़ तुमने बोला कि एवोल्यूशन का तो दोनों साइड में है, एंड नाउ आई एम प्रीटी श्योर कि यू हैव नॉट लुक्ड इन टू द अदर साइड ऑफ इट. सिमिलरली आई एम सेइंग कि हर एक चीज़ का पक्ष विपक्ष होता है. फ्लैट अर्थ वॉज इज नॉट समथिंग न्यू ऑफकोर्स. ऐसा नहीं है कि अभी इंटरनेट आया और मीम चलने लगा तो लोग फ्लैट अर्थ करने लगे. बहुत ही पुराना, 150 साल पहले से लोग बुक्स लिखते आ रहे हैं और ऐसा ऐसा. जस्ट बिकॉज कि कॉमन नॉलेज में इसको नहीं लाया गया या आम जनता को नहीं बताया गया कि ऐसा भी कुछ कर रहे हैं लोग, इसका मतलब ये हो गया कि वो चीज़ क्रेडिबल नहीं है? आर यू सेइंग कि देर आर टू मेनी पीपल ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ द आर्ग्यूमेंट एंड टू फ्यू आर्ग्यूइंग फॉर द ट्रूथ? महात्मा गांधी का कहानी एक कोट था कि क्या, स्पीक द ट्रूथ इवन इफ यू आर इन अ माइनॉरिटी ऑफ वन. तो ट्रूथ इज ट्रूथ इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ कि पूरा दुनिया क्या बिलीव करता है. अब एक्चुअल फैक्ट तो यही है ना कि या तो गोल है या फ्लैट है. बहस हम लोग जिंदगी भर कर सकते हैं. आई होप कि जल्दी लोगों को पता चले, बट ट्रूथ इज द ट्रूथ. तुम कुछ भी मान सकते हो, हम कुछ भी मान सकते हैं. हो सकता है कि कुछ और ही है, ट्राइंगल है, राइट? किसी को नहीं पता है. लेकिन ट्रूथ फाइंड आउट करने के लिए सबसे पहला चीज़ क्या है कि ये जो दिमाग में ऑलरेडी इंडॉक्ट्रिनेशन भरा हुआ है, कम से कम आई विल नॉट अफेक्ट माई ओन थाट्स टू बी अफेक्टेड और इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाई अ लाइफ लॉन्ग ऑफ इंडॉक्ट्रिनेशन एंड सोशल प्रोग्रामिंग. हर एक चीज़ जो हम देखते हैं, तुमको क्या लगता है कि यूनिवर्सल का कोई मूवी देखते हो या बचपन में हम लोग का दूरदर्शन भी आता था, एक ग्लोब घूमते घूमते आके बन गया, तो ये कहीं ना कहीं सबलिमिनल प्रोग्रामिंग नहीं है
कि एक चीज जो प्रोग्राम दैट इज द बेसिक थिंग.
बस सो व्हाई आर यू अवर्स टू रियलाइजिंग इट और एक्सेप्टिंग इट कि नहीं, जो हमको बोला गया वो सही है, क्योंकि साइंस और थियोरी और ये सब कुछ हम बोल रहे हैं कि ठीक है, वो सब तो अपने जगह पे भी है. नाउ आई वॉज देयर. ठीक है, आई कैन कम्प्लीटली अंडरस्टैंड कि तुम्हारे दिमाग में क्या चल रहा होगा या फिर तुम क्यों इतना डिफ़िकल्ट है किसी के लिए भी फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एक्सेप्ट कर लेना. देयर इज दिस कॉग्निटिव डिसोनेंस, बताया था, आई थिंक वी डिस्कस्ड इट आल्सो. कॉग्निटिव डिसोनेंस वो फीलिंग ही है कि कुछ जब नया तुमको बताया जाएगा एंड दैट गोज अगेंस्ट योर, यस, दैट गोज अगेंस्ट सम ऑफ द कोर बिलीव्स दैट आर डीपली हेल्ड बाई यू, देन यू आर गोइंग टू रिजेक्ट, इग्नोर और इवन डिनाई. तुम डिनाई कर दोगे कि नहीं, वो जो फोटोग्राफ दिख रहा है 400 से ज़्यादा किलोमीटर का, वो कुछ कुछ ऐसा रिफ्रैक्शन वगैरह, और ये जो हम बोल रहे हैं कि नहीं वो दिख रहा है क्योंकि वो है, राइट? जो अभी तुम बोले कि इफ़ वी कंसिडर अ थिंग वेरी ह्यूज तो वो दिख जाएगा, दैट इज़ राइट. एक माउंटेन दिख रहा है 400 किलोमीटर दूर, राइट? एंड उसका जो हमको ये भी दिखता है, होराइजन भी दिखता है. होराइजन हॉरिजॉन्टल नाम ही इसीलिए पड़ा है कि ऐसा. नाउ यू आर सेइंग कि हम लोग एक बारी में जब ऐसे देखते हैं तो वी कैन सी 100, 150, 200 किलोमीटर भी अक्रॉस देख लेते हैं. दूर का तो छोड़ दो, लेकिन ऐसे जो एक होराइजन देख रहे हैं ऐसा. अब हाउ मेनी स्ट्रेट लाइन्स फॉर्म अ बॉल, जो तुम पहले बोल रहे थे कि इट इज़ सो स्मॉल. जितना भी स्मॉल हो, मिनिस्क्यूल ऑफ कर्वेचर भी अगर होगा, तो आज के डेट में हमारे पास इतना पावरफुल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हैं, टेलीस्कोप्स हैं, कैमरा है, कि अगर एक रत्ती भर में मिलीमीटर का भी उसमें कर्वेचर है कि तो हम निकाल लेंगे कि हाँ कर्वेचर तो है भाई. हम बोल रहे हैं कि कुछ भी नहीं है, जितना भी आज तक देखा गया है, कैलकुलेट किया गया है, इट इज़ ऑल फ्लैट. हाउ मेनी स्ट्रेट लाइन्स मेक अप अ बॉल, कि वो एक बहुत बड़े बॉल का एक स्ट्रेट लाइन है ना. अब उसके नेक्स्ट वाला भी जब हम एक मान लो अपना व्यू कंप्लीट यहाँ से यहाँ चेंज कर लिए, उसके नेक्स्ट वाला भी स्ट्रेट लाइन ही होगा. अब तुम बोलना चाह रहे हो कि यहाँ पे कहीं ना कहीं हाफ अ डिग्री का एंगल होगा और उसका नेक्स्ट वाला स्ट्रेट लाइन थोड़ा नीचे होगा, देन स्ट्रेट लाइन थोड़ा नीचे होगा. आई एम सेइंग कि ऐसा नहीं है. वो स्ट्रेट लाइन अगर हम ट्रैक करते जाएंगे तो जितना दूर करेंगे वो स्ट्रेट ही रहेगा. ये तो तुम भी मानते हो. एट व्हाट पॉइंट देन वो जो सर्कल है वो स्ट्रेट लाइन बनते बनते सर्कल बन गया. और क्या बोले, सबसे बड़ा एग्जांपल तो यही है कि वाटर लेज फ्लैट सिंपल. स्वेज कनाल वगैरह, कनाल जो बनाया जाता है वो एक सी को दूसरे सी से जोड़ने के लिए किया जाता है. एंड वी यूज टर्मिनोलॉजीज विच पॉइंट टुवर्ड्स अ फ्लैट अर्थ एवरीवेयर. सी लेवल बोलते हैं हम लोग, वाटर टेबल बोलते हैं हम लोग, फॉर द सिंपल रीजन कि इट इज लेवल.
राइट,
स्वेज कैनाल कितना, 100 miles, 150 kilometers, पता नहीं एग्जैक्टली, बहुत ही लंबा है. अब जो तुमको कैलकुलेशन बताया कि पर मीटर माइल्स स्क्वायर्ड इंटू 8 inches, तो उस हिसाब से कैलकुलेट करोगे तो तुम सोच लो 100 में कितना होगा. बहुत ज़्यादा ये होगा. अब कंस्ट्रक्शन करते वक्त अगर उतना कर्वेचर होता तो उस टाइम के ज़माने का इंजीनियर्स के लिए उसको फैक्टर इन करना बहुत ही ज़रूरी होता, बिकॉज इट इज़ अप्रिशिएबल. अब तुम बोले लाइट कैन बेंड, एवरीथिंग कैन हैपन, बट वाटर कैन नॉट बेंड अक्रॉस द सर्फेस. हम लोग वाटर का बिहेवियर जानते हैं, कहीं पर भी छोड़ देंगे इट लेज फ्लैट. ओवर 100, मोर देन 100 kilometers स्वेज कैनाल को जब कनेक्ट किया गया, देयर वॉज ओनली थोड़ा सा फ्यू फीट का ऊपर नीचे था. एंड दैट इज़ द बेसिक रीज़न वाई द कनाल वर्क्स. क्योंकि एक पॉइंट से दूसरा पॉइंट अगर वाटर का सेम लेवल नहीं होगा तो एक जगह से दूसरे जगह वाटर फ्लो कर जाएगा. राइट, तो उसको मेंटेन करने के लिए उनको कंस्ट्रक्शन ही ऐसा करना पड़ा कि पहले कैलकुलेट किए कि कितना फीट का ऊपर नीचे है, एंड देन उस अकॉर्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्ट किया सो दैट दोनों लेवल पे वाटर जाके मीट कर जाए. और भी ऐसा बहुत सारा एग्जांपल्स है. कॉन्स्पिरेसी थियरीज हम बोल रहे हैं, जैसे 9/11 फॉर एग्जांपल. इसका जो हम लोग को एक स्टोरी बताया गया है कि कुछ लोग प्लेन हाईजैक किए और ऐसा ऐसा प्लेन उड़ाया, उसका कितना सारा ये है, मतलब अल्टरनेट एक्सप्लेनेशंस है. ये अमेरिका के लोगों से अभी जाके पूछोगे तो मैक्सिमम लोग, मतलब इंडिया में तो ठीक है, हमको क्या फ़र्क पड़ता है वहाँ पे क्या हुआ था. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग कि US जो कि दुनिया का सबसे पावरफुल कंट्री है, उसके लोगों में या फिर उसके गवर्नमेंट को एक वैसा स्टेज्ड अटैक अपने ही देश में करवाना पड़ा. उसके बाद हम लोग इवेंट्स क्या क्या देखते हैं कि वो लोग इराक में गया, जो भी वो लोग को करना था, ऑन द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ दैट टेररिस्ट अटैक वो लोग किया. अब अगेन एज क्रिटिकल थिंकर्स तुम सोच सकता है कि जैसा वो लोग बोल रहा है कि आतंकवादी आया, ये किया, वो किया, उसके बाद वो लोग गया वहाँ पे इराक में, बोला कि वेपन्स ऑफ मास डिस्ट्रक्शन है, पूरा देश को तबाह कर दिया, मिडल ईस्ट को आज भी जानते हो कि तबाह कर दिया, एंड देन बोलता है कि ओके ठीक है, नहीं मिला हम लोग को वेपन्स ऑफ मास डिस्ट्रक्शन, नहीं था उसके पास. अब हम ये मान के चल सकते हैं या फिर हम क्वेश्चन कर सकते हैं कि नहीं भाई, कहीं ना कहीं तुम लोग का अपना फ़ायदा था, तुम लोग को घुसना था मिडिल ईस्ट में तेल के लिए, और इस वजह से तुम लोग का अब बोलो ऐसा कोई क्वेश्चन करता है. तो अगेन अगर मैक्सिमम लोग ये मानते हैं कि नहीं जो बताया गया वो सही है, उससे क्या होता है, उससे क्या फ़र्क पड़ता है. हम अपना दिमाग तो लगा सकते हैं. सबसे चूतिया कौन होता है दुनिया में पता है? मासेस. क्योंकि मासेस को कंट्रोल किया जा सकता है. शीप, हम लोग भेड़ चाल,
यू गिव देम अ पर्टिकुलर थॉट और आइडिया, दे विल फॉलो ऑल द
भेड़ चाल. अनदर टर्म कॉन्फ्लेटिंग दीज टू इज शीपल बोलते हैं. पीपल हु बिहेव लाइक शीप आर कॉल्ड शीपल. मेरा तुमसे बात करने का एक ही एम था, डोंट बी अ शीपल. कि दुनिया में सीपल का कोई कमी नहीं है, एक ही चीज़ जो तुम अपने आप को डिफरेंशिएट कर सकते हो इन द बेस्ट पॉसिबल मैनर. यू कैन ऑल्सो डिफरेंशिएट योर सेल्फ बाई गेटिंग अ जॉब इन गूगल मे बी. सो वो भी तुमको डिफरेंशिएट करेगा कि इस कॉलेज में किसी को भी गूगल में जॉब नहीं मिला, इसको मिला. बट वट इज़ मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट इज डिफरेंशिएट करो कि आई एम नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन. हम मासेज में के साथ भेड़ चाल में नहीं चलते हैं. आई हैव अ माइंड ऑफ माई ओन. हर एक जगह पे हमको अपना दिमाग लगाना आता है कि क्या सही है क्या गलत है. एंड आई ट्रस्ट माई ओन सेंसेस, माई कॉमन सेंस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, मोर देन एनी बडी एल्स इन दिस वर्ल्ड. हमको अपने पे ज़्यादा भरोसा है रादर देन साइंटिस्ट्स जो थियोरी दे रहा है और क्या क्या कर रहा है. सो आर यू कन्विंस्ड दैट द अर्थ इज फ्लैट, और एटलीस्ट यू आर गोइंग टू लुक इन टू इट?
Pretty much I will look into the facts that are given.
Okay. ठीक है, काफ़ी है इतना. और वेट, ठीक है चलो, आई थिंक वी आर डन हियर. थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर दिस.
I see you've made it through to the end of the video. A smart and intelligent budding engineer talking to a person who confuses between East and West quite a lot. Yep, that's me. I'm Flat Arthur on Twitter. And if your head is exploding with questions about Flat Earth, you can direct all of them there. Also, let me know your thoughts in the comments section. हम तो भाई फ्लैट अर्थ पे चर्चा करेंगे, किसी से नहीं डरेंगे. You were listening to Flat Arthur dropping the penny, and I ain't going back. I'll leave you with this beautiful thought.
Once an idea has taken hold in the brain, it's almost impossible to eradicate. An idea that is fully formed, fully understood, that sticks right in there somewhere.